So when we talk about rural India, what kind of people are we looking at here? So the kind of audience that we had was people who were living in the villages. The villages that you will take time to reach because you will have to change at least 3 modes of transport to reach there. Then the people who are living there are not very well educated. So that's another challenge that we saw. Then there was no electricity in the village, which came to us as a surprise. Like, it doesn't feel like that's going to be a concern in this age, but there were no electricity. There are charging stations in the center of the village which are running on solar power, where people go and charge their cell phones when they use it. Then they use basic phones, so no smartphones there or anything like that. And basically they need health support. So this is the premise of the kind of audience that we are looking at. So what is the current state of public health? I think a lot of people have spoken about this. So there are community health centers, which is at the top level of the hierarchy, which are managed by the states. Then there are primary health centers, there are sub-centers, and there are non-government infrastructures. So we're going to be talking about non-government infrastructures. So in the non-government infrastructures, there are private hospitals and there are non-profit hospitals, which are run by people who are basically concerned about, say, one aspect of health. So there would be some non-profit which will be concerned about, say, women and childcare. So they have budgets for doing that kind of work. There will be some other non-profit which will be interested in taking care of TB for particular villages. So they'll be having budgets for that kind of work. So these hospitals, they basically run community health services where they keep track of this data and also provide services to the people who are living in villages. And as a part of this and as a part of community health program, there is a very old system which was devised in 1970s. It's called Jamkhed. So what happens basically there is the community people, they nominate someone from their own village to learn basic things about health, and then they train the people in the village to take care of themselves. So that's a basic system. It's been working around for a long, long time. So they are basically called village health workers. That's the term that we'll be using so far. So they're trained into giving consultation. They're trained into prescription and having basic healthcare. Then the reason that they're also picked by villagers is also because whenever people as the government visit from outside, they're always seen as people whom they don't relate to. There are cultural barriers that they come across and they don't feel very comfortable because they still see them as outsiders. So the whole idea of someone being picked from a village also builds this default trust factor, and it makes it easier for those people to get through. Then they're basically responsible for one village. So so one person who's a part of that particular village will be talking about will be talking to the people who are there in the village about their basic health and taking it forward there, as compared to, say, sometimes government health officers where they have to manage more than one village and go to different types of people every time. So how do they operate now? So right now they use paper. Whenever they are trained in the field, whenever they are trained, after they go back to the field and they have a sheet of paper which says basically these are the symptoms and these are the treatment for that. And that's a very sort of rudimentary way of looking at how you would do healthcare. But they're not trained as doctors, so that's the best they can do with what they know. Then they can't always identify edge cases or emergencies because those are very subtle things that they are not very well aware of sometimes, because they are not, again, trained in trained as being a doctor. Then they aren't aware of patient's history. So sometimes it also leads to complications which they aren't aware of whenever they provide any treatment to any patient who's visiting them at the at their offices. So they are not able to provide that. And they don't have a proper track of medication for the patients. So a lot of times when villagers visit these people for, say, basic health, and they need to restock their medication, but the villagers have not come back. These guys don't remember that, okay, they probably should go and check up on that fact, because all the work that they're doing is fairly manual. It's all put in registers and like it's a lot of data for them to go through, and they basically sometimes end up forgetting this. So this is where the product that we worked on came in. So it's called Open Community Health Service, and this platform basically works as the village health workers who will be our users, and they'll be providing healthcare solutions to the patients, the villagers who will be visiting them. So the same people who are being nominated by the community, they are being trained into using this software right now. So this was done in collaboration with Samanvay Foundation. These are a group of technology folks who are experienced in building these products, and they work with nonprofits and government into trying to solve the problems that we are coming across. And they're not simple problems there. So the kind of challenges I kind of ran through already, that there was no electricity, there were physical constraints. So as compared to the kind of things that they're looking at, it's not just pure data collection. It's not just saying that, okay, this is the amount of fever you have. It's also, say, taking their MRI, taking their BP, and all those kind of things actually leave you to have more physical constraints. Then there's localization and multi-language support. So in each village, since we are developing our digital application, right? So all the villages, they definitely speak different languages. In Maharashtra, they speak Marathi. In Karnataka, they'll be speaking Kannada. And in each place, they would be using a different dialect. That being said, there's also another challenge that they use different terminologies. So at one place, they'll be using different terms for one particular factor that they'll be recording, and for at different places they'll be using different terminology for the same thing. So we had to also localize the application for that. And another challenge was ease of use, since we know that the people whom we are working with here are not particularly tech savvy, so we had to sort of design according to that. So how we solved are these challenges, like first thing was to make this offline. So this app works completely offline. We know that the health workers are like 98% offline. Whenever they come back and visit a place or a health center which has proper internet connection is when they have this sort of facility to sync that data. So it's data that they have been collecting over time in the field. And the app basically works offline, and they visit, say, once in a month or say more than that sometimes to sync this data. So this data will be synced directly to the server, and the nonprofits or whoever is in the bigger system, they'll be having track of this data. Health workers which are there with us, we know that they have only very basic understanding of things. So say things like, how do you deal with previous history of a patient? They won't be very cognizant of how to take care of that. So what the app does is basically it has a decision support system, which the algorithm which was built by in collaboration with a lot of stakeholders and people who know that the kind of solutions which need to be provided for any problem. So it gives you a solution according to that. And in the treatment itself, it tells you that this is the medication you need to take, for how long you need to take. And if there is any emergency concern, that they also tell that, okay, you need to go to the hospital for this particular reason. Then localization. So for multiple language support, what we have done currently is that at the time of implementation of the app, it would be designed, basically there'll be an implementation design separately. So whenever you go to the place of, whenever you go to the nonprofit and you know that this app is going to be used by this villager in this particular state, you localize that app for that particular area, convert everything which is being said in that particular language, and use the terminology which is existing for that, which also eases the use for those people. So when they're out in the field, they don't face the challenge of understanding what they're really doing. And then basically keeping it ease of use. So a lot of times the apps we wanted to make, it also feels like they might just end up being bloated because we want to do a lot of things. We want to collect a lot of data. So what we tried to do was just keeping it focused, focusing on one aspect, which is just providing one feature of giving people treatment as much as possible. Then the kind of iconography that we went for, that was also another challenge we were looking at. So we were thinking that let's try to make it something simple, or let's try to make it something that the people will be able to relate to. So it's in something very Indian context, and it's a very tempting thing to do, but as you realize that it's not going to be working in one part of or one village of one state, right? It's going to be implemented at multiple places. So what we tried to do was try to keep it as simple as possible, keeping it schematic, taking a 5-second rule that, okay, if you're not able to understand that icon in like 5 seconds, then that's not worth it, and say keeping multiple dimensions of the icons quite distinctive. And then understanding behavior. So there was one alpha version of this app which was released to just see how they interact with data collection. If they're giving fields, how do they behave with it? And the interesting thing was that they swipe after looking at the screen. And these are the people who have absolutely no clue about how to use smartphones. So that was getting us closer to how do we really deal with their behavior. App is yet to be released, we are working on development of the final thing. It will be implemented for one village first, and we'll be looking at how the feedback will be, because they will be trained. So like village health workers are trained into each and every aspect, they will also be trained into how to use the app. And that's where we'll be getting our first level of feedback, and we'll be improving things accordingly. Second level of feedback will have a bigger loop, where they would be gone in the field for months probably, and when they come back is when we'll be able to understand what all problems are they really coming across when they're in the field. And the next thing is, say, that's when you get to a point where you scale things. So yeah, that's the plan for now. The project is under AGPL license right now. The source code is completely open. Question that comes here, since it's a data conference, it's like, is the raw data going to be open? Probably not, because it's health data. So you don't want someone's personal information being out there, especially health information. What would be the future could possibly be that maybe aggregated open data can be out there. We don't know yet what it's going to be, but possibly this could happen. And looking at the documentation of the project, you can just go to this website, and on the website we have pretty much everything documented. So this is a project still in running, and we'll be looking at things every day. So we have a source code here, we have Trello, which we are using for our design and development things as well. And all the other documentation, our approaches that we have taken, everything is pretty much available. So if you have any thoughts or any questions, you can just hit us and let us know what you're doing.